Welcome to Inside New York. I am so delighted to have back on the program theater critic Jeanette Toomer and veteran theater goer Patricia Rivera to talk about this year's TONYS and what you need to see next right here on Inside New York. So we welcome you ladies. So good to see you both, Jeanette and Pat.
And it's good to be seen. And thank you, Joan, for inviting me back.
It's been a historic year for Blacks on Broadway. 7 new works by Black playwrights opened on Broadway. And that was very well acknowledged, I think, in the opening special event that Ariana DeBrow presented, TONY's Night.
This season featured new shows written by 7 Black playwrights. Yeah.
What'd you think of the intro, her performance, and the entire TONY's Night? Jeanette?
It was very exciting. I mean, I thought it was exhausting too for her, because she danced, she sang pieces of Broadway songs from years ago, which brought back memories for all of us who've been, you know, who know some of the older Broadway musicals. And that was fun to hear. That definitely was fun to hear. And she was so versatile and graceful, wonderful singing voice, very strong. Can sing high, can sing low. She was exciting.
What did you think about her performance?
I thought that she is the new Broadway star, and she's going to give Adrienne Warren of Tina a run for her money. The woman was authentic. Her voice was amazing, but she has a beautiful smile. You just want to look at her. You felt like she could be your neighbor. She made you comfortable. And for something like the TONYS, when it's all this posing and other award shows that everybody's on, she wasn't like that. This girl was great. I thoroughly enjoyed these TONYS and her.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I thought she was a perfect choice. She is not only a magnificent young star who just happened to have won an Oscar to boot, and that's remarkable in itself that she's not only a theater star, but also a film star with that level of recognition. Yet at the same time, she's rather young. And it seems as though she just like blew up overnight, because I remember seeing her in Motown the Musical. And she was, I can't even say. She was obviously one of the singers. Performance, but I don't think she was one of those leading roles, so to speak. She might have been part of maybe the Supremes. I think that's where she performed. And I spoke with her at a Broadway after party, and she was so just warm and approachable. And it was just remarkable to see that she still had that same kind of approachability, that just everyday girl that you might see your neighbor, et cetera. She was not at all full of herself, and it was refreshing. And yes, she performed constantly, singing, dancing, you know, speaking. It was like triple threat doesn't even describe it. I can't imagine it not being exhausting for her, but she seemed to really revel in the exhibiting all of that. So it was a great way to start. And also she did make mention of the fact that this was a big year for African-American playwrights, the importance of diversity, and of course the LGBT community, because it's Pride Month, and of course it's Broadway. So we have a lot of that segment of our population involved in Broadway theater. So it was a wonderful, I think, convergence of the two. Now, having said that, what was your favorite moment of the evening? Jeanette, we'll start with you.
Well, I have to say, Phylicia Rashad was so classy and so statuesque when she gave that speech accepting her Tony for Skeleton Crew. I just thought, this is really someone we have to keep watching. She is a grand dame of American theater, black and white, doesn't matter, okay? She has ruled all the stages. I remember seeing her in Gem of the Ocean, August mm-hmm. Wilson, you know? And it seems that no matter what she's in, she has that air of class and grace, you know? And I just love that about her. And her speech was awesome. So I have to say, before that, I was watching a lot of speeches and listening, but you could hear a pin drop when she started talking. You really could. She was excellent.
Well, I go in a different direction. I thought that Myles Frost receiving that award as MJ, I enjoyed it. It was classy. He came up and he did his little Michael Jackson stick. I wanted to see more of it. And he made the Tonys exciting, because that's what you're watching for. You're watching for excitement, somebody that brings more than authenticity to it. The boy's a natural. The fact that I read a little bit about him. He'd only seen one play in his life before he got this. He was in engineering school and as a junior when they got him for this role. So just seeing that his gratefulness to his mother, it impressed me. I love that. And I also favorite that's Joaquina's solo performance. That song, it stopped. When she went on and on and that voice didn't stop, I said, where is this going? I haven't seen Paradise Square, and I do have to. Those were my favorite moments.
Yes. Well, you ladies summed it up for me as well. I have to say, the outside of the opening, which as I mentioned, I think was a grand way to start. Certainly opening next, I believe it was, with MJ's Smooth Criminal, performed by Myles Frost. That just set the patient, kept the locomotive moving. As you came to the window, with the sound of a crashing car, he came in for a bottle and he left the dust stains on a carpet. She went under the table, he could see she wasn't able. So she fell into the bedroom, she would drop down, it was a joke. Kept that excitement and performance, which is why you come to Broadway. You don't come to Broadway to hear speeches. You come to Broadway to be wowed. And Myles Frost, I cannot say enough about that. It is definitely one of my best picks of the entire season. We'll go into that later. But that performance of his, and of course the cast, was just amazing. And then somewhat closing with the performance by Joaquina, Kalukango. That was another wow moment. It was a great way to bring the entire Tony's night together. Her performance of
Let It Burn.
That was amazing. And having just seen the Paradise Square, the one production I hadn't seen that I wanted to see before the Tonys, but having seen it afterwards, she deserves getting the Tony for Best Lead Actress by far. But we'll talk about that later as well. Thank you for joining us for this week's program of Inside New York. And you can watch more of our interview on our YouTube channel. Don't forget to ring the bell when you subscribe so you'll get an alert when it's available on demand. And we'll see you again next week with our best picks for you on Inside New York.